Let's have a look what would be the optimal point of consumption in this case. And let's do it on the same graph so that we can connect everything. Now, recall, just like with the simple budget constraint, we also have an indifference curve. And let's suppose this would be the indifference curve in our case. And we have a tangency point. What does the indifference curve shows us in this case? So let's write it over here. The indifference curve here shows us the set of combinations of consumption in the present and consumption in the future for a certain utility level. Which means that the slope, the point that is tangent, the slope, the line that is tangent to the indifference curve shows us the willingness to exchange consumption in the future for consumption in the present while keeping the same utility. So the slope of this indifference curve shows us the willingness to exchange consumption in the future for consumption in the present. Meaning that if we want to consume one more unit, one more good in the present, how much do we have to sacrifice from the future while keeping the same utility? And let's say that utility would be 100 units. So we still can have 100 units even if we consume over here slightly more in the present and slightly less in the future. That's the intuition of an indifference curve. Now the question is this: when is this optimal? When is this the best that we can afford? Well, the best that we can afford should be on the highest indifference curve possible. Now the highest indifference curve possible is the one that's actually on the budget line, because by definition we are affording it, since the budget line, the budget constraint, shows the limit of money that allows us to exchange consumption in the future for consumption in the present. So by consuming on this point of tangency, we are saying that the willingness to exchange consumption in the future for consumption in the present is the same as the capacity, as how much we can actually trade consumption now for consumption in the future. So the extent that we are willing to, the extent that we literally use common words here, the extent that we want to exchange is the extent that we can exchange. The money allows us to. That's why this would be the tangency point. Now, how do we call this slope? Recall that for a simple budget constraint, we call it the MRS, right? The marginal rate of substitution. The willingness to exchange goods at the margin. In this case, we're dealing with time because we're trading time, consumption in time. So it's a marginal rate of time preference. Literally, how much time we prefer now versus later. Do we want more now or can we wait later? Are we patient or are we impatient? That's what this marginal rate of time preference shows us. And if the marginal rate of time preference shows us the willingness to exchange consumption to for consumption now, meaning that we would like to have a bit more now instead of in the future, how much do we have to give up in the future? By having a bit more consumption in the present, we have a marginal utility in the present and we give up a certain marginal utility in the future. I hope this ratio makes sense. Once again, we are consuming a bit more now and we give up something in the future. From this additional consumption in the present, we get an additional utility. And from the lack of consumption, from sacrificing consumption in the future, we also give up potential utility that we could have had. And the rate at which can allow this is the rate at which the budget line affords us to. That's why this ratio has to equal to the slope of the budget line, which is equal to what? 1 plus R. So the MRTP at the optimum, let's write it like that. The MRTP at the optimal is equal to the slope of the budget line. That's as good as we can get. And I hope this makes sense. This is a bit less intuitive than the two goods budget constraint with the MRS, but the logic is exactly the same. The additional thing here is that we'd have to discount the consumption. We have to discount the time by the interest rate. So that may be something slightly uncomfortable. But if you understand the intuition, the analogy, the similarity between this and the MRS, everything is going to make more sense when you go through webcasts more, when you solve more questions. But I hope the intuition makes sense, and we are done.